back to critiquing the social justice warriors of the internet, one thing I want to get across is that I've made an epiphany. While I was on Facebook, looking at my newsfeed, seeing all the kids from my high school that are now college douches, this nerdy Asian guy, could be Filipino or something because he has those little mystique-like features, he shared on Facebook something about a game-changing thing for females, how it's going to revolutionize the way females view their own beauty. It was about the same guy that changed Barbie's proportions, and so now she's like shorter and waist is bigger. She's thicker. She looks like the average female. Well, now that guy made a new female that's athletic and white and is strong. And this person said it's a game changer. Not really, just show a more attractive looking athletic doll. I mean, this isn't a fat thing, it's just a thick, kind of looking muscular at the right places looking doll. And you have the balls to say that's anything like the previous change you made or from a previous project. No, get the fuck out. I myself have no interest in the design of Barbie. I think that she's kind of meant to look a little like something from the 50s or 60s where girls had smaller waists. At least the successful models did. Even if they were more thick in other places. I'm sick and tired of this fallacy that girls back then were huge compared to now. Like, okay, maybe their thighs touch, but that doesn't really mean shit. If you consider the hip to waist ratio, which ultimately plays a more significant role. But that got me to thinking, because I commented that the new Barbie design is pointless, but this new chick is cool. And I got likes from multiple females, and a lot of them said the same point as me. And it made me realize that this SJW bullshit, while it is fruity and it can find truths and put them in a way where they're ridiculous, all because they're living in fantasy worlds. And in that case, they're a lot more harmless when they're contained to a social setting. It's when they become a political thing that they become harmful and carcinogenic and detestable in general. When they start picking on conservative visia memes, concepts, beliefs, beliefs, the whole shebang. That's when it becomes detestable. When you have Macklemore releasing these satirical songs making fun of conservatives that are proud of being American and that they're gun toters. Kill yourself, Macklemore. Now, not even black people or hood guys like you because you took away Kendrick Lamar's chance at winning the Grammy, I believe. So when you took that away from him, now you only get the love of some swippers that don't really follow that. You kind of lost any chance you had of making a difference When it's political, it's a problem. When it's one group trying to engage in political strife against another group, you have a legit problem. That's kind of why the healthcare issue is interesting for me, because Swipples are mixed on it because the healthcare issue, while the Obama administration is trying to make it seem as cool for a SJW Brahmin hipster type as possible, that pajama boy and some of this other corny stuff, like, it's not effective at all, by any means. But some people will continue to support it because it pisses off the teabaggers. Now that's a problem. Because they know, even if the healthcare system doesn't harm them, they don't care because it pisses off another political group. And some guys see through that and they call it out. And they're not white guys. Because they know that political shit is another level from what we're normally dealing with. That is one group trying to engage in political violence against another group. Then at that point, your views are no longer just your views. They're asinine statements. Made engage in political discourse and violence. And that's kind of where I sound like a voluntarist or an ANCAP. Where I was talking about free speech, but if you advocate for the state, then you're engaging in violence. Well, I'm obviously adding another dimension to it. And it's one that's more practical because it really only affects a smaller percentage of the population. That small percentage is really damaged. That's what I'm worried about. This new game-changing doll or stuff of that nature, that whole everyone is beautiful no matter what meme, when it's contained to a social level, it's harmless. But this kind of stuff, this, even to piss off the teabaggers, the gun toters, the conservatives, that Kurt Cobain bullshit, that's when it needs to stop. And I hope it stops soon enough. This is Mr. Wonka 7, and suck my dick.